The Thomson Belle started his life all back in 1987, running up and down the Maroochy River as the Ginger Belle.
Okay, everybody, I'm going to unwrap this in a minute. You're going to pretend you're a dairy cow. Get your nibble, your crackers, vegetarian, vegan, gluten-free, celiac, whatever you need. Past here, keep coming out this way.
So this is the Thomson River at Longreach, which is the water supply for Longreach. This is sunset, absolutely magnificent. Also an interesting point, just north of Longreach, not very far, is the geographical dead centre of Queensland. So we just learned that today. So it's only like 5 km north of here. It's nothing.
This is one of the roosters.
I think he's going to lay an egg.
He's our light. He's our shelter in bad weather. I love the world we'll never understand. This wasted land. It just sits on sinking sand. Together we can make it in our Savior's hand. A house divided won't stand. A house divided won't stand. A house divided. It just sits on sinking sand. Together we can make it in our Savior's hands. A house divided won't stand. A house divided won't stand.
There's a spirit down under that lives on the wind, the sea and the sands of our big country shores. It's a spirit that roams through our valleys like thunder, then screams through the ridges and chills to the core. It lives in the silence that stills the red center, in the wilderness reaches that fill us with awe. It lives in the hearts and the souls of Australians. In dream times before us, we can't ignore. The spirit runs high, and the spirit runs deep. That spirit within us is with us for keeps. It's the spirit that I see. We all share with the grim. It's the spirit of Australia. It's the spirit to win. It lives in the grey floods that cover the flatlands and bushfires that blacken square miles as they roll.
So Sharon, now you start.
It's the way you look at it. But look, Jeremy just going to poke along, and as you can see, he's taken off the belly wall and taken her off up around his crutch and that a little bit before we got in. He's tucked him out a little bit before we got here, just so he knows that he's got, hasn't got a kicker. But normally that sheep would come out, and that valley wool and that hushy wool would be taken off first, and the rouseabout was running around here, getting all that and pushing it away, and they flick it out there like that, and get it away from the main fleece that's going to come off, because they're placed there, and these bull boys come running through here, they probably don't like a real. They've got to run. They've literally got to run, and they come running through there, and they grab that up, they'll flick it over their shoulder, and they'll end up in one of those bags, the right bag, where this one's got their job to do. Because you've got to remember, every 3 minutes is a fleece dropping off of it. And every 3 minutes, there's 6 fleeces getting thrown on that table for the park and the class and getting to the water. So it becomes a second hole. You're dropping on his feet, you're not pushing away again. And he's back in there and he's getting out of there. And when he steps in here, this is a mistake he's making the other side. Those fat hands have got to be charged up, pull up here. If they're not, the pen are up against the back. Because the spirit cannot be a forward running around unless it's the end of the run or the end of the day. He can make the hands get a bit loose. But he can't afford to be running around in there trying to catch another sheep. He's got to be able to grab a sheep there and drag it out. Get caught, see me. But, you know, everyone's got the job of jamboree and bringing the sheep in for the next day's shearing. They've got to be off the water for 12 hours before they put them on the floor. So they've got to be coming in from the back country. They've got to be taking the shear, torn ones away, back out to the back country. That's the art of a good shearer, bringing the wool off, and because that all reflects in the wool.